And together, we're Scrappy
Sew and So.
So welcome again to another episode. I believe we're on episode 9. Okay, it's been a while. We've had trouble getting our schedules to jive. It's been a busy time of year.
Yes.
And we are actually in my little corner of paradise today, which is my basement and where I would love to spend all of my time, but managed to squeeze out a couple hours here and there. You don't see the mess. You don't see the mess. I'm not a hoarder. It's just sometimes things get dumped down here when...
Who can say who's a hoarder?
I just bought a new Christmas tree, so that's kind of taking up some space down here. And I got a new sewing machine, which is a Brother PQ1500. That's all I can see because the box is right there.
Oh, right.
But my name for it is Bro, right? He ain't heavy. He's my brother. In the immortal words of Neil Diamond.
Is it a smaller one? Did you buy a smaller one for traveling?
No, I didn't. And this one is definitely probably just as heavy, if not quite as heavy as my Janome. But it's a semi-industrial machine, so it'll go through the thick layers of fabric that I want to do to make sort of bags. But you can use it for quilting as well. It's only a straight stitch. It does not do any fancy stitching at all.
Oh.
But it goes super high speed. In fact, I was a little bit shocked and a little scared when I started.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was like, whoa! You know? Okay, so speaking of my new sewing machine, last weekend I sewed the prize for this month. So this is what we are giving away for the month of November, which is the eyebrow. Yeah.
Yes, that's what we're working on right now, row I.
And the reason why we decided to give this away is because we are, I think out of all the things that we've ever had on the show, it's like everybody always asks about the book that you
yes.
have. It's like a booklet pouch. So the pattern designer is Anila Hui. I think that's how you say it. Okay, it's got a little separating zipper on the outside. Okay, and
that's
then...
That's cute. I like the color she used.
Yeah, I didn't... I mean, like, I love tulip pink. Melissa loves tulip pink. We all love tulip pink, but not everybody loves tulip pink. So I figured instead of doing something that I really love, I thought maybe I'd try and make something a little bit more neutral.
Yeah, right? It's sewing themed. It's nice.
So it's like on the outside, it's kind of like more of the funky modern sewing themed. And I put a little bit of a cork Scrappy Sew and So. I made a stamp, but I couldn't get it to print properly. So I used the Janome and did the lettering and embroidery just so that I could sew it down and get it ready before I get it all started. So there's a more modern fabric on the outside, and then on the inside is like the vintage sewing machine, but which coordinates nicely with buttons and vintage scissors. And then if you notice, there is like a zipper pocket on each one of these quote-unquote pages, right? Mm-hmm. And that's where you get to store like your stuff.
Yeah, it's perfect size for like your finished row or like your finished blocks of what you're working on, and then like parts for other pieces.
And you can see it without opening it and stuff like that, mm-hmm. right? So that's the prize for the month of November. The sponsor is not me, Instagram 26. It is Scrappy So and So, right? We're like McCartney and Lennon. Right? So it's Scrappy So and So. So Scrappy So and So is a sponsor, so you just have to make sure that you tag us. I will try to take a photo of this and post it on the blog, which I tend to neglect sometimes, but I've been really busy at work and stuff mm-hmm. like that. So, yeah, that's the prize for row I, which is actually, I don't know, how much have you got done in row I?
I'm working on my first one.
It's not as bad. I find there's a lot of sewing machine blocks
yeah.
for me on row I, and it's...
A bunch of 9 patches. I already traced them out and stuff to do them. Foundation paper piecing.
So you'll have to work, but it won't have to be that hard, right? So... That is the prize for I.
I'm worried about December already.
Why? Because it's just a busy time of year.
This is a busy time of year. I'm like, well, I better look. I wonder how hard the blocks are going to be in December. That'll be J.
It'll be H-I-J, yeah. I know, sometimes
there's a few easy ones, and then there's a few that look like...
That one looks like Hell's Bells.
Oh my gosh, there's a basket.
Oh, that's the one with the basket. Oh, Christmas basket.
It's the one with the basket.
You know what? I'm going to make my basket like the right way up. That drives me nuts that it's not the right way up. Because if you look at it from the side, it doesn't look like right like a basket. Well, look at those little teeny tiny 9 patches.
Yeah.
Okay, so instead of just pointing at the paper, maybe we should point at the screen. And...
Oh, yeah.
Not point at the screen, but point at something that our viewers can see. So, I don't know what's going on over here. All right, so we got to talk about two rows because, like I said at the beginning, we did not talk about the G row. Mm-hmm. Who was our sponsor for G? Was that Hobbs Batting?
G was Hobbs.
Yeah.
And H was the, I sent the Melissa Marginette book, the quilting book.
Okay, so G was tough, right? It was it was hard work to do. The
I finished my G after I finished H.
So okay, so
of that star block. I already sewed mine together.
Yeah, they're starting to look really good when they're like all sashed and stuff like that.
I love it.
All right, so G1, and you are in order.
I'm in order for once.
So the G1 was Hattie's Hen House.
Mm-hmm.
You must have. Did yours?
I needle turn applique these ones, each little petal, and then machine sewed them together.
I EPP'd mine. You see the messy back. Actually, it's not that bad because there's only like 8 pieces in this one as compared to like a 40 mm-hmm. piecer.
Yeah.
Those ones are starting to like wear me down and age me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, next one is Mohawk Trail. I think I had to take this one apart and restitch it because I didn't do it right the first time. Like, I didn't line up the blocks in the correct order because you really got to look at it
mm-hmm.
When you're doing that one. Totally machine piece, this one. Yeah.
I love this block.
Me too, and I used the new Libs Elliott fabric on this one, and I like the difference between... It wasn't actually new. It was new to me. It was like an older collection. But
I feel like this would be a really nice block. Like if you blew it up to be bigger, it would make a nice quilt.
Yeah, I know some of these would make really nice quilts if they were a lot bigger, right? It's like sometimes you finish them and you feel like you've done a quilt.
It'd be nice if it was this size too, but no. I'm not going to do that.
Not going to do it.
Not going to do it.
Wouldn't be prudent.
Mm-mm.
Okay, the next one is...
It's a clover looking thing.
Oh, hang on, I got a page here. Four leaf clover, yeah. Didn't love this one, did it?
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't that hard, but at the same time, it was challenging to make it look nice. I don't know.
Yeah, my needle turn is...
I like the contrast in colors in yours. Yours looks a bit rounder. Mine looks like a plus sign. But I didn't want to redo it.
No.
I didn't love it enough to redo it.
No. When I was sewing them together, I was like, oh, this one's not, some of them aren't very nice. But then I thought, nope, I'm just going to sew them together. Okay, and then it's done.
The next one is Shutterbug. It's basically like an economy square and an economy square and an economy square times infinity.
Mm-hmm.
I actually paper pieced this one, foundation paper piece, I got some scraps of paper. I don't love that method, but I'm like, if I don't do it that way, I'm never going to be happy with it,
mm-hmm.
right? Because it's just like so tight and tiny. Again, this would make a great quilt if it was blown up large.
Oh, yeah.
But
that'd be gorgeous.
That would be. Let's do that someday. Let's just make a big quilt mm-hmm. with economy squares over and over and over again. And it would also be great for a really large print, right? Because you'd be able to see the large print when you got to the bigger pieces. Those two fabrics. It'd be an easy one. Totally easy if it were bigger. Okay, next one is Poof. I think I complained about Poof on Instagram. I didn't like it. How did you do Poof? Just total needle turn?
No, I machine pieced these.
Oh, the cross?
The cross in, and then I did the poof over top.
I
needle turn.
I did mine completely English paper piecing.
The needle turn blocks seem to be the ones that I get finished because I can sit with Blake in the evenings and...
Yeah, it's not... Yeah,
it's not like stealing... I'm not stealing time.
Okay, the next one. Okay, yeah, this is the one I was talking about. Jenny voluntarily made an extra one of those. So Jenny Seb's mom at Seb's mom on mm-hmm. Instagram. Okay, so this mm-hmm. one was that star, the 5-point star with the star on the inside. So Jenny voluntarily made that one, and I was giving her a shout out when I was talking about that. This one was a challenge.
Oh, yeah.
I think I foundation paper piece the center star, and then I EPP'd it because I couldn't get the point, like, these pieces of fabric to match up properly. So I think, yeah, I probably stretched it a little bit. I don't even know if it measures 5 inches squared.
I foundation paper pieced the whole thing.
Did you?
Well, no, not the center. The center, I just, like, pieced. Tried to do, like, and it's super wonky.
I'm going to lose the point on that side.
And then I foundation paper pieced these pieces. Like, I cut it apart. I went to that quilt blog and...
said, help me, please.
And, yeah, because I finished it, like, it was one of the last ones that I did. This one and this one... This was, like, the third time that I made this block. This was a real stinker for me.
So that one, the 5-point star, is called Papa Star. I don't think we said the name of it. Next one is... little Yentl there. Indianapolis. Didn't enjoy this one too much either. There was just some little pieces. English paper piece. That's what I don't like about English paper piecing is when the pieces are so tiny that there's like more fabric than cardboard. Mm-hmm. It's like I feel like I'm all thumbs and it's really annoying. But it turned out okay. I like the fabric. This is actually Libs Elliott's new one, the greatest hits volume 1. So I like the contrast in that. It was nice to use a different fabric for a little bit because I was getting kind of sick and tired of it. And I'm sure I'm going to lose those little pieces on the edge. Just saying.
I foundation paper pieced this part. And I needle turned applique the circle. I think I needle turned applique the circle and then cut it apart. Put the other pieces in.
It looks nice, though. It looks nice and flat.
Mm-hmm. If you don't look too close.
Okay, the next one. This is the one that you said that you did 3 times.
Yeah, and I already lost a little corner there.
Justin's Comet is the name of the block. I EPP'd mine. It's not too bad. I remember it taking a while and being like, ugh. But whatever, it's done.
I machine sewed it. And I... had the Y seams to deal with. The other one wasn't good. It was like, it's like 2 inches too big, and I don't know how that happened. But this one, I sewed these parts on last. The background.
Yeah.
Almost like a reverse. I have no idea. But it's done.
It's done.
And it's passable.
Okay, next one is G9, Mary's Journey.
I like this one.
Yeah, me too, actually. And I don't think I lost any points on it. It was, yeah, it's pretty... You could do it all by a straight-up machine. Mm-hmm. And I don't think I did paper piecing because I can't see any evidence of it, but I honestly cannot remember what I did for that one.
I just machine pieced it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. I got a lot of bits and stuff on here.
There's a lot of, yeah.
And then the next one, I remember you saying you liked this one too, right? The woven metal?
Yeah, I machine pieced it, and I think this is one of the first ones I did for this row. And but mine is like, it's a little bit wonky.
It's super flat though.
I starched the bejesus out of this thing, like... Oh, look, yeah. At it. All the...
Oh, look at
I had to open all of the seams to make it big enough to try because I think my seam was a little too generous.
You put a border on yours as well.
Yeah, and I had to put a border on it because it wasn't big enough. It wasn't big enough one way and it was too big the other way. And...
But it looks so nice.
So, yeah, this one took a lot of, like, trying to iron it into submission and... But I think in the end it looks good, and even though there's like a little like one less than a quarter inch border on it, I don't care.
You can't really tell from a distance. No. But it does look nice. So the next one, that one was called Woven Meadow, and I think I said that already. So the next one is Decisions. So this is a pretty straightforward block. I know I did it on the machine to start off with, and I needle turned the diamonds on it. Mm-hmm. But I'm not happy with the way that my needle turn looks, right? And then when you look at this from a distance, you can see them popping up. And I saw somebody, and I don't know if they're Ukrainian or Russian, because it was like the language was different under Instagram. They did this block, but they must have paper pieced the diamonds into the rectangle before sewing it together, which inspired me to try to do that on row I, which we're on right now, which was a lot more work and a big waste of fabric, but I'm happier with the way the block looks. So I think in the future I might try to do that, either that or at least cut out the fabric behind and leave the paper inside until I'm done needle turning it, because I just, sometimes it just, I can't get the corners right, and it's not hard, it's not a hard technique, but I just feel like mine looks so crummy, right? And I'm gonna be sorry later on.
Well, I think pointy corners are probably like one of the hardest
things
to do. That and like the inside, like of like a petal, like, or a heart, like the top of a heart. I think that in, because you have to like cut it just to like two threads. That's the hardest part.
But yeah, yours looks nicer. You can't see your stitching, but the silk thread.
Love that silk thread. And I just bought like six more spools.
We went to the closing, unfortunately, of another quilt shop. That was what, 2 weeks ago today?
Yeah, I think so.
And yeah, it was their last day, so pretty much everything was 40% off. And yeah, Melissa picked up some awesome varieties of silk thread.
I didn't even realize. Yeah, I didn't realize that they had it, because whenever we went on a shop hop, I was like buying like the last roll, like the last spool of silk thread from like a bunch of different stores.
And there's always so much to see. Yeah, but like, it's just when you go in a shop, they have everything put out there, and you can't see everything. Like, you never see everything. So
that's. But I got tons of colors. So now, like, I look at that. I'm like, that's a lot of.
Good variety. You probably never need
good variety. Yeah, there's like, I have like 15 spools now, and I'm like, when you think about the money,
you need a little case.
Well, I have that wood antique one that's in my living room.
Yeah.
That I have to like move some furniture around so it can sit beside my chair. It's got all of my.
All of your sewing
and sewing stuff.
And sewing goodies. Okay, next one. I kind of like this one. English paper pieced it. You can see there's a lot of seams on it, but it turned out pretty good. And again, I used the new quilt, Liv's Elliott fabric for the blues. And just having that little bit of extra variety gave me a bit more motivation to do it.
I really like that shade of blue.
The light blue or
the light blue?
Yeah. Yeah, it's nice. That shade. It's almost like a powder blue.
Yeah. It just has like, I don't know, it's got a nice depth to it.
It has a je ne sais quoi.
Okay, well, this is Glorie. This is, I used otter and shell from Tulipink, squeezed it in.
You got to use your otter.
Got to use it. Fussy cut the otter.
And you did yours in one big piece, whereas I did mine in separate pieces.
I just needle turned applique the otter guy on there, and then put the borders on. That's it.
And then again, the last one, again, this is another example of how I'm not happy with my needle turn applique. This one's called Molly's Muffins.
I didn't even needle turn applique this one. Look, I just like rounded it with my fingers and then sewed on top with white thread.
Not buying Molly's Muffins.
Mm-mm.
Okay, so that rounds off the G row.
But this is my favorite white fabric.
That is nice.
It's got like a little metallic bubbles on it.
And who won the prize for G-Row? Do you remember who it was?
G-Row Hobbs. I think that was So Nick.
Yeah, So Nick. Okay. Yeah, so congratulations to So Nick. You definitely earned it because that was a tough row.
She has all those pretty and pink blocks.
Yeah. Yeah, they are really nice.
Mm-hmm.
And they're very crisp.
I know.
Very crisp blocks.
If she didn't live in Australia, I'd be asking her
come over
to come over and show me how she's doing those.
Okay, so that's G row. Now we're on to H. So how did you find H? Was H better?
H was better. I finished it on time.
Re-loop.
So I was happy about that. And yeah, there are some stinkers in this one too. And some easy ones.
Mine are out of order. I think. There we go.
I just have to find which end is the top.
This
one. Yeah. This is Peekaboo.
I started English paper piecing some of the ones that I know that I could do by machine anyways, just to see if I could do them neater and better with foundation paper piecing. Plus, I also had my Genomio, which is what I prefer to use for the foundation paper piecing because it cuts the threads, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to have to switch machines because the antique machine I usually use, the vintage one, it doesn't even have a thread cutter on it. Like, it doesn't even have the little thing.
Step into the century, lady.
I know, but it's a great little chain piecing. It's great for chain piecing. That's what I like it for. But mm-hmm. I had the Genomio out, so I did the foundation paper piecing, which I'm pretty happy with for this block. But I will tell you a story about another block later on about the nightmares of FFPP. Right.
Yeah. I haven't touched another machine since I bought that Janome.
You're just, yeah, I you're just so
love
loyal.
It. I just love it. I like the other ones are just gathering dust. One I lent to my sister. I mean, it's a good machine. It's fine. It doesn't have the thread cutter.
Thread cutters are amazing.
But yeah, it's all about the thread cutter.
Bro has a thread cutter. But yeah, I have a serger. That's what I like. Usually when I'm sewing clothes, the majority of the clothes gets on the serger. But yeah, I just found that the Janome doesn't quite go through the layers of fabric that I want it to go through. Whereas the Brother is like a hot knife through butter.
Mm.
Okay, next one. What are we looking at here? Oh, this one was called Peekaboo, by the way. Jacob Anthony. Yeah, this one I EPP'd.
I have no idea, honestly.
Did you machine piece it?
I machine pieced it, and then these ones, I needle turned applique the little corner guys on there.
Yeah, I did that as well.
Oh, look, there's paper. I think I must have foundation paper pieced. How I did, I don't know. I think, you know what, like, I haven't been, like, looking at the blocks and mulling them over and figuring it out. I've just been, like, really relying on that quilt blog spot because just already got them all figured out and I just don't have the mental time to do it anymore.
Yeah, fall's busy, right? Fall is busy.
December, I'm going to be on that thing all the time. Well, this one's really wonky. Look at that.
Look at the center of mine. It's like, it's totally off. I used
foundation. Are they supposed to be like this?
Yeah, they are.
Oh.
I foundation paper piece this one, even though I probably could have done it without the foundation paper piece. I probably could have done it straight up machine, but I thought, you know what? I want to try doing the foundation paper pieces. Is there something I'm missing? Look at how nice your seams are. You just straight up machined it.
I did.
Yeah, it looks great. See, with the foundation paper piecing, I'm off in the center by a quarter of an inch. It's hard to see with this fabric.
I lost my point there, but...
Can't win them all?
Honestly, I don't know. Lately, I just hate anything with the flying geese.
Yeah.
Anything with the damn triangle in the middle, I don't want anything to do with it.
Okay, the next one. Okay, so I have been reading Margaret Atwood's The Testaments, which is a sequel to...
Handmaid's Tale.
And I was working on this block when I was doing it, and... One of the expressions from that book is under his eye. So every time I looked at this while I was working on it and I was reading that book, I was thinking under his eye, right? It was creepy.
Creepy.
Right? So I was kind of glad when I was done. So this is Abby's eyes. And I have a niece named Abby. You have a niece named Abby. We all have a niece named Abby. Right? But yeah, under his eye. I think I'm going to rename my block under his eye.
Ooh.
Yeah, creepy. Creepy. If you haven't read it, it's really good. Read it. Kind of, I guess somebody told me it makes more sense if the if you're watching the TV series as well at the same time. But it made sense to me, and I haven't watched all of season 3. I only watched a little bit, and then Mark and I said, forget it. Like,
season
it's just
3 was creepy.
Yeah, it was just too much. Too much creep. The creep factor. I'm wondering if this one's actually wide enough. It doesn't.
And they're taping it in...
Cambridge.
In Cambridge, so like sometimes we'll see stuff.
Under his eye.
And it's pretty creepy.
Okay, the next one. I don't know why it's called Michael's Motorcycle because it does not look like a motorcycle to me, but this is Michael's Motorcycle.
Mm-hmm.
I have a feeling when I'm actually sewing this together, like what Melissa did, I'm going to have to stretch it out a little bit because it does not look wide enough. But I foundation paper pieced this one, so that I would be happy with it. And I actually am pretty happy with it, although the contrast on the colors isn't the greatest. Mm-hmm. But
I think I just straight up sewed it, and there's some points that don't match, but we're just going to move on from that.
We're just, yeah. We're going to be grateful.
Moving right along. This is pie sale.
Oh, they did not like pie sale. Did not want.
I like it.
I did my English paper piecing. There's a lot of little pieces. Took me a couple of days.
I did this from the way that the lady said to do it on that...
That quilt?
Blogspot, which is like... This part is the top part.
It's reverse applique.
Yeah, it's kind of like... It's... I don't know. I think it's... I don't know. This is needle turned applique, the red on top of here. And then it's this blue is needle turned applique on top of the red. This is the background.
Yeah.
It's like not the way my brain thought to do it at all, but it worked out perfect.
Yeah, it does look really nice. It lines up.
I'm happy with it. It does not line up perfect. And I think I was using a marking pen that is not as erasable as it should be. So there's like a little bit of a silvery mark on it, which hopefully goes away.
Okay, the next one is the Bennington Star. Okay, so I found a paper piece, this one. You can see the back. I really like this blog, not because I really like the way mine is done. It represents the start of getting to use new yellow, because I think yellow has been like the burden I've had to bear with the colors that I chose, right? And this one's two new colors of yellow. They're both from Liv's Elliott tattooed collection. And it just, like, it has a nice contrast.
I like that yellow.
They go together nicely. It just, like, it's like a ray of sunshine. And it's going to be in the middle of my quilt. So, yeah. Because this is...
I feel like I have a yellow like that, but it's not the Liv's Elliott. It's, no. Like...
So this is the same as that blue like that you like.
But it's a very close pattern.
It's over this side, I think.
Like the fabric looks.
Yeah, it's
really
the same
close
as the blue. It's just a different tone. See?
I like that.
Yeah, so this is like, you know, why I like that black so much.
I like the way this one came out. I made like, I just made the hourglass ones and I made them way too big and then cut them down to size. And
a nice contrast between the fabric and the background there.
I like the way it turned out.
That's the way. I need to pick a song for the video. Try a couple out. Okay, the next one is Eaton's Crossroads. Like, I'm wondering if they're thinking about Eaton's, like the store Eaton's that closed. I don't know. So
did they have that in the States? I thought that was just Canadian.
I don't know. I'd have to Google it.
I remember it in Montreal.
So, the method of choice for this one. So, I EPP'd the center part. So, you can see that here. And then I machine pieced the four corners together first and then onto the EPP. Because I wanted it to be flatter than the way that my needle turn applique tends to turn out.
Oh, yours is nice and flat. Mine's like a button. It's like... I guess I could cut out the back. I just sewed... I like took a red block and cut it into four and then sewed the bars in between. And then I used one of my perfect circles. This isn't the right size.
Carrie K. Buckley.
Yeah, this my circle isn't the right size, but this is the size that I had. The biggest Karen K. Buckley, yes, perfect circle. And I did it like that and I'm happy with it. I'm like at the point where I'm like, I don't care if the circles are the exact right size. I just want them to be round.
You know that Bonnie Hunter Facebook group for the Quilt Villa I was telling you about? I think it was on there. Somebody had a picture of the Karen K. Buckley perfect circles. And she had said, what are these things? Because quite often people will inherit sewing baskets, right? And it was like...
Lucky ducks.
Yeah, so... And I wanted to, like, you know, big letters, Karen K. Buckley perfect circles, but I think that the only person that would appreciate it from me would be you. And you're not really on Facebook, so...
No.
Yeah. But, yeah, they're... by, like, after, like, a minute, like, six people had already commented, said Karen K. Buckley, so...
Yeah. I know. That's what... In the beginning, that's what people were telling us. Get those circles. Yeah. And we searched.
I haven't used those circles yet.
You haven't used them?
So far, I have not used them yet. Okay, next one, Snowflake Melt. Again, my contrast is not the greatest on this one. But I FPP'd the block. And then I just needle turned the diamonds on top.
Yeah, I think I just made half squares, triangles.
Yeah.
And then I think mine is actually the reverse. And it said something, because I looked at that quilt thing and they said, oh, you have to do the mirror or whatever. And somehow I did it wrong, but then I was like, I didn't care.
I think mine looks exactly the same as yours. Yeah. Because I FPP'd it. And it's always the mirror image, right?
I have no idea. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, ours look almost the same. We have, like, the same purpley color.
Okay, so let me tell you, okay, about this block. Because this block was one of the ones that I did FPP. FFPP. Definitely FFFPP for this one. Because I don't know why. I mean, I ended up, for the final version, and I it's got a little crinkled, and I didn't press my seams open at the back. This is the only machine pieced version of the block. I FPP'd it. I actually kept it because it looked so nasty of my FFPP. And it actually had me doing Y seams for this block.
What? How?
I don't know. I don't know why the computer program decided that on this particular one, let's make Eve do some Y seams. So I got to about the last couple steps of the block before I noticed that I was going to have to do a Y seam. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, what up with that? So then I tried to fix it, and then the block just looked nasty. So this is the second version of this block. So I gotta say, it does. And I like the colors on this one for sure. Like, again, this is the newer fabric for me. It's the Libs Elliott Tattoo.
Oh, I really like that fabric.
I know. Great contrast. It looks great. But yeah, FFPP, you're not selling yourself on me when you do stuff like that.
Well, I mean, for some things, like I see some of those patterns, the foundation paper,
the sweater pattern, right?
Yeah, like they're like so cute, like the, you know, like the little modern. But some of these, it's like they should just be straightforward. But yeah, it's just because they're so small and it's so hard to get it perfect that foundation paper piecing sometimes is the only thing to do.
And speaking of foundation paper piecing, like, we actually put out a pattern of foundation paper piecing. If you go to our blog, you can download, it's like a little envelope. We called it Melissa's envelope because Melissa really wanted an envelope. So you can go on to
find the pattern anywhere.
On the link?
Yours. Oh. I found.
Oh, but that's why we made it.
Yeah, because I'd find seen, like, on Flickr all of these cute envelopes, but
couldn't find it. So it's a 6.5-inch pattern. Make sure you don't, like, I know if I try and print it off my iPhone, it messes up the sizing. So print it off of, like, an actual computer, unless you can mess with the sizing, because it was a 1/4-inch off on one side when I printed it off my phone versus when I printed it off my computer. Oh, really? So keep that in mind. Okay, make sure you measure it. It's going to be 6.5 inches. I should probably put a test square on there, but when I figure out how to do that, I will do that. It's all a learning curve.
Absolutely.
Okay.
This is Piercing Rays.
Piercing Rays. Straight up EPP.
This is like a needle turn applique, and this is, what the heck? Yeah, the center, this is like, oh gosh. This was a hard one. This is foundation paper pieced. There's like a hole in the back. It was really weird the way that, but it turned out not too bad. Oh my gosh, that doesn't look square at all. It turned out not too bad, but this is the way that she said to do it on the that quilt blog spot, which was, my brain would never have figured that out. I probably just would have needle turned applique these little things on there, but I was trying to get it done in a timely manner.
Next one. There's not too many ways to do this except for needle turn applique. Yeah. But you notice that mine is nice and flat. And the nice edges. And you know why.
Why?
Because I left the cardboard in the shapes and cut it out after.
Oh.
So from now on, if there's anything that is big enough to do this, I am totally doing it this way.
I didn't do that.
Because it was even a more enjoyable process of sewing the hearts onto the block mm-hmm. when they were still wrapped in paper and I didn't have edges flopping around all over the place. Oh, yeah, totally.
Does Look at how flat nice it is. In the, like, can yep. you still pin it down okay?
Yep. Hmm. Even with those little teeny tiny pins that you gave me. So, yeah, from now on, that's what I'm doing.
Well, this is farm fields, and this is just straight up sewing on the machine.
Did I needle turn it? Yeah. No, I didn't needle turn that. Did I make it extra complicated for myself? Actually, I did foundation paper piece this just because I wanted to try to see if it made it absolutely perfect. Mm-hmm. Did it? I don't know.
I don't. Mine's not going to be absolutely perfect.
All right. That was pretty fast, two blocks. What was this one called again, that cross? Farm fields,
yeah.
Okay.
I'm happy with my choice of the tulip pink. What's that one called with the blue?
Making waves, I think. It's from True Colors.
Yeah. It's an older one.
I got some Monkey Wrench. I have some. It's not all of it, but it's some of it. So there's some Monkey Wrench right here. I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but I kind of feel like I like it better when I saw it in person.
I like that teal color. Yeah. This is the first time I'm seeing it in person.
I like this one with the rainbow bugs. But like, I'm trying to think about what I'd like to make with these, and I'm thinking maybe some bags and pouches. I like this one too. Yeah. See, all of the I don't know what they're called, but like the secondary kind of prints, they're really nice. I think even that one's nice too when you see it in person, but when you saw it on like a computer screen or whatever, it did not like get me excited. Mm-hmm. It's the same with like the cat food cans. Do you remember that? It was like, I'm not putting cat food cans, but yeah, I like using them now. I like finding special spots for the cat food cans. So that's why when I saw this, I did buy it because I thought that I will like it. It will grow on me. There was another, even the holiday homies grew on me because I didn't love the holiday homies initially. And speaking of the holiday homies, we were going to talk about Christmas, weren't we?
Oh yeah. Cause I recently saw my holiday homies in the giant stash and thought I should really make a Christmas quilt. You've made a lot of Christmassy things, haven't you?
No, I did make a Christmas quilt. The only Christmas fabric that I've ever, like, willingly bought has been Holiday Homies, because I'm not really, like, a Christmas fabric kind of person. Like, I don't love poinsettias and whatever, right? And I don't like the idea that you spend so much time on something and it could become something you only use that's seasonal. But I thought if I did make a Christmas quilt to put in my living room, then we'd get it out every year. So, anyways, I did make a tree skirt. And because we're in the My Little Corner of Paradise today, I can sort of show this sort of. So I made a tree skirt because, and this is the story behind the tree skirt.
Oh God, the dog.
The dog. So I've posted pictures of my dog on Instagram, so hopefully you've seen him. He's a little bit of a pain, and he is a part Cocker Spaniel, and I've learned recently that Cocker Spaniels like to pee everywhere, right? Lucky me.
I did not know that.
Lucky me. So my dog pees everywhere. He peed on the tree skirt last year, and they had the kind of style of tree that I could not take the tree skirt off until I was taking the tree down. So we had to sit there and look at a white tree skirt with sprays of pee on it. I mean, I tried to cover it up and stuff, right? You know, it's like I'm bare and all right now. So anyways, the idea was that I was going to make a tree skirt with a zipper on it so I could unzip it and wash it whenever Otis peed on it, which is going to happen. It's inevitable. And then I decided just this week, I went to Costco and I bought a new tree. And I actually don't need a tree skirt for this tree because the base of it, it's actually right on the floor there. The base of it looks like a base of a birch tree and it's like kind of attractive. So, and this tree skirt is just like a massive, it's like 60.
Oh.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew it together and it's perfectly round and I'm going to use it as a little tablecloth, but it is holiday homie. So that's I can attempt to show you parts of it because yeah, I fussy cut the homies. This actual print is not from Holiday Homies. It's from the cat's Tabby Road.
Oh, it goes so good.
It goes perfectly. That's a little like trick, right? It goes perfectly and it looks like a candy cane because I cut it on the diagonal. And I used the pattern for, I don't know what it's called, but it's a tulip pink pattern. It's like a bullseye pattern. That's the bullseye pattern. I just added the scallops because I want to practice my scallops for when I do my Dear Jane quilt. And then I added a little part in the center, so I only need to actually need to applique a circle in the center. That's like probably about 6 inches.
That's not bad.
Sorry, I can't show you the whole thing, but like it repeats itself. So yeah. That's so nice. One of the goals is to quilt this. I have so many things I gotta do before Christmas. I'm not really a Christmas. I made, because I have a lot of scraps of these, I made a table runner. I made a quilt. And then I still have scraps left, so I'm gonna try and make myself a holiday homies vest to wear to school, because the kids will just love that. And I would like to make a matching one for my dog, because he does not like wearing his coat, and that's what he gets for peeing on my tree skirt.
It's like punishment.
Yeah. If you're going to pee on my tree skirt, you're going to wear an ugly vest. And then, so you're
thinking... I'd like an ugly vest, but I don't want to pee on your tree skirt.
Okay, well, I might make you an ugly vest, too, if I can. I've got a great plan. It's just having the time to do it, and I... taking on more responsibility at work and stuff like that, I haven't been able to like get her done like I normally mm-hmm. do, right? And maybe I'm just getting old and not having the energy to, like, I get home from school most days and I'm tired. So.
Yeah,
I need another summer, like right in the middle of the year.
Yeah. I'd like summer. I'm not enjoying the like instant winter, November. Beginning of November, there's snow already.
And darkness.
I mean, I know this is Canada, but come on. This is ridiculous.
We just put our clocks back last weekend, so it's like dark at 5. It's like you wake up and it's dark out still, especially if it's not a nice day, and there's more of those not so nice days in November. And then it's like mm-hmm. you get off work at like, you get off work at like 7.
Yeah, it's
you probably don't even
black.
See
no.
like outside when you're at work. So it's like you go there in black and then you get off at black.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, the world is just black.
Yeah.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. Yeah. So winter, but the thing is, it's like, and it actually snowed. I mean, we don't really live in like a super snowy area of Canada. Like, you know, we're actually on par, I think.
We're actually like more southern than a bunch of the states.
Yeah, most states. Yeah, for sure. Like those Midwestern states get way more snow than we do.
Mm-hmm.
But it actually snowed this week. And, you know, like, people are like, oh, my God, winter's coming. Because it's not actually officially winter either. But I don't mind the snow myself. Like, if it's before Christmas. I mean, it's a little early right now, but it's still, you know, before Christmas. So it's like, you know, it kind of puts you in, like, a little festive mood. January, no thank you, snow. No thank you. Like,
but, like, last year, I think it lasted until March.
Yeah,
it did. Or later, or April. Like, 2 years ago, we had, like, a warm February. I don't know, it's just making my mood really.
See, for me, if it's really bad weather, they cancel school and then I get an extra sew day, which is always a blessing. But poor Melissa has to drive to work in like the nastiest conditions to mm-hmm. Yeah, without any kind of recourse, right?
Yes. And then I have to be thankful that my husband works from home and I don't have to figure out something to do with my kid at 5:30 in the morning.
That is a blessing, yeah. That's true.
Yeah. I don't know how some people do it.
I know. Without having family around, like a grandma, grandpa. For sure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, we should probably wrap up the video. I kind of forgot it was still rolling.
Up. Yeah.
All right. So again, the prize for this month. We know a lot of you have really liked this pouch. So
mm-hmm.
finish your blocks. Tag Scrappy So and So. And use the hashtag Dear Jane Quilt Along. Yep. You're not going to be sorry. And it's not a hard pattern to make, but it is kind of a bit of a pain because there's a lot of binding.
And a lot of zippers.
A lot of zippers, a lot of binding. So
yeah.
Not having to make it's kind of nice, and
it's
you can
nice,
appreciate
yeah.
it. So there
well,
you go.
And people who sew very rarely get a gift that is sewn because you just never think of making something for somebody who sews. So now you do get one.
And quite often you also make stuff for other people, never for yourself.
Yeah.
Right, because people always like something that you've made and then you end up making it for them, but then you don't keep it for yourself. So it took me a long time to make one of these for myself, but I did. So I should have brought it down, mm-hmm. but it's upstairs. So yeah, so this is our prize for the month for...
last month, did I say already that Paula Claussen
was our winner,
and she got the Melissa Marginette quilting book. It's really, really cool book with like lots of geometric designs on like
for your walking foot.
Walking foot.
If you're not quite brave enough to try the free motioning yet. And I gotta say, like, that one actually was full of great ideas. And it's like one of those spiral bound ones, so you just put it right beside your machine. You're like, mm-hmm. I need an idea to fill a square. Boom.
Yeah, it's an awesome book. Like, I've used it a bunch of times. I bought two because I thought maybe I would give one to my mom, but then she's not ready for it.
Yeah, I'm glad. I mean, I have a lot of quilting books that I don't use, but that one I use, and I actually keep it out by my machine. Mm-hmm. And it's actually not big and bulky and in my face. It's sort of a nice little reference guide. It's great.
Yeah, it's really, really handy book. Like, there's a million ideas in it for how many pages there are. It's a really good resource.
Yeah, so, that was our prize. And we actually sponsored it because Melissa had bought two copies.
Paula, it's signed by Melissa Marginette, not me.
Yeah. There you go. Right, I mean, we could have signed it. We could sign this if you want. No, you don't want us to. We got a little Scrappy Sew and So logo on it. All right, so you still have quite a bit of time. It's only November the 8th today, so there's still well over, 3 weeks in order to finish row I.
I think I can do it.
You can do it. I think I got 6 blocks done, so I'm getting there. But I want to get it done so I can work on other stuff. So I can do some subversive embroidery or cross-stitching for Christmas presents.
Nice.
Okay. So happy sewing, right? Start checking stuff off your Christmas list, and we'll talk to you in December.
See you next month.